Hi, good evening, everyone. So it's just for this week is the best. Next week is going to be somebody else. So I'm going to begin my speech soon once the slide comes on. Tonight, I'm going to take you into my world called Bukakistan. It's basically a make-believe world where everything good is blur. So it's all, but the photography that I do is largely to do with out-of-focus effects. So yeah, so you could call me the blur photographer. I think that's a very apt description. So I spend a lot of time taking blurry pictures with hardly anything in focus, although sometimes I have to take my wife in focus, so that's how I still alive. I use a lot of very old lenses, right? Like this, for example, you won't really see this kind of effect from modern places. And this, for example, was taken in Ginza. And the nature of my street photography, if you can call it that, is that I spent a lot of time outside and I view a lot of taxi tops. I've been collecting thousands, okay, exaggeration, hundreds of taxi top shots like this. So this is something that I enjoy doing a lot. So for bouquet photography, you'll be looking at choosing backgrounds. Like this, for example, Christmas. It's in Shinjuku. And the great thing is, you always find bikes. And you have bicycles who don't move, who don't make noise. They just stand there, and you can have fun shooting it. This is in Mongkok in Hong Kong. And that is probably on the top floor, 13th floor. But it was beautiful grid of LED lights. It was, to me, it was like made for me. So I just went in and everybody was looking at disco ball. I was looking at the lights. So I just went up there and I took a shot. This little boy I love, I met him at University Road Park. So confident. He was all dressed up. Now, how does bouquet link it with him? Well, the spiral bouquet, to me, helps to accentuate that the sense of drama. For me, bouquet photography also works very well in product shots like this. Let me just tell you, I mean, the background is nothing but a crumpled up sheet of aluminum foil, right? So you could do this at home. It's not something difficult. You don't have to go to Tokyo. You could just do this at home, or you can do this anywhere in the toilet. This is on my kitchen top. This one combines double exposure photography with bouquet photography. So basically what you get is, I took a shot at an exit sign, this is in Japan, right? Then I saved this and I went outside and I took another shot and there you go. Something like this, something abstract, just something whimsical. So it's, you know, it doesn't have a serious message. This is done on film, black and white film. In the Shinjuku, Sancho Mei, I was just walking around, there was this beautiful lady, at least from the back, and I took a shot of her from the back and basically quickly go the other side and looked at the road and just took the other shot. And because it's black and white, it's very easy to manipulate afterwards. This is also a double exposure. This is a little bit different in the sense that this wireframe thing was in Times Square in Hong Kong. So what I did was I covered half the camera lens. So you only see half of the robot being shown. And the next frame, I put it on blur and I shot the street scene so you could see the merging of that. An opportunity to talk about the gear now. So I have with me the Leica M9, which I used to shoot all the shots before. You could use any camera, and you know, you don't really have to use this. Film cameras, because of the fact that the film is so big, and you could have a lot of blur effects. But I love these micro four-third ones, because you can do crazy shots like this. Right, where you have the eye in focus, the taxi's in focus, that's in focus, but everything else is not in focus. I mean, to me, this is crazy, it's nuts. It's not your traditional way of looking at photography. I don't even know what to call this. It's just me being, you know, whimsical, and I just like something like this. This was taken in Seoul, and again, I was waiting for my wife, who's seated in front here, yeah? And while she was shopping, so I was just waiting. And lo and behold, you know, this lady was just walking by. A bit about this technique, what I did was basically remove the lens from the camera and you move it around until you get a spot that you like. So basically, it's detaching. I was walking across from Takashimaya to Paragon during Christmas, and again, well, I had my lens detached and I saw this girl who was kind of pretty looking. So I decided, okay, let's take a quick shot. This happened probably in the space of 2 seconds. So she's in focus, kind of. She's in focus, but everything else has gone crazy. You know, it's like you step in the time warp. I tried to do this at the Fullerton Hotel and during the F1. Everyone's F1 shot is, you know, cars whizzing by or with grids, or, you know, with a fence, and you can't really see much. So what I tried to do was to get the car and the bunch of people. They look like miniatures, look like matchbox toys or something like that, right? So, yeah. This is the Sydney Harbour Bridge taken from the Mandarin Hotel in Sydney, obviously. And we applied this to architectural photography in the sense I think it's interesting that you get to see the lights and you get to see parts of the structure that's clear, and most of it's not clear, but it invokes that sense of adventure to me. This taken at a club, and pretty much like this, except they were launching the new BMW 6 Series, and they had this beautiful stream of LED lights just over the top, and I had one of these tilt lenses. They just tilt, and you could, you know, show the enlarging effect of lights, and this pretty girl just happened to walk past. This was in Shinjuku, that's NTT Docomo Tower, and I called this it's time for bokeh. Essentially, the bokeh elements are the out-of-focus lights, so it's all zoomed into the time. It looks like a time warp. Bokeh actually came from the Japanese word verb bokasu, which means to blur things. This is Roppongi, and I was walking down Christmas again, and you know, it was the first time I actually came this direction. But it was great because, oh my gosh, this is a great opportunity to do some of these crazy, wacky shots. And the moment I took the shot, they turned off the lights, so I was quite pleased. Anybody, this is familiar? Marina Bay area, right? So again, one of these, these two were so nice to oblige me by walking down slowly as I prepared to take this picture while waiting for my daughter. Again, I'm always waiting for somebody, and that's why I'm taking pictures like this. Okay? And this is my son, and the story behind this is interesting because the poor boy had to walk around Gardens by the Bay with an umbrella, with a flash in there. As we're walking through the garden, I was firing my, remotely triggering the flash, and he was annoying everybody in there. You could imagine the amount of aggro. Thank you very much for listening. Do visit Bokekistan soon. Thank you.